Hello everyone, I am Nisha Mukherjee, a student of Shivanath Law College and presently interning with Lexis & Company. Today I am going to analyze the new education policy of 2020. Everybody is very excited about the new education policy. The first education policy was introduced in 1968. The second education policy was introduced in 1986 under the Rajiv Gandhi government. Then it came the modification that was done under P.V. Narasimha Rao government in 1992. Then after that, our new education policy have come, that is in 2020. It seems very perfect on paper, but obviously the implementation will depend on time. Now, the right to education was introduced because of the importance or increasing importance of the education, and it was made a fundamental right of free and equal education to the children of age group 6 to 14. Now, it was seen that in 2014, the manifesto of BJP talked about the new education policy. Smriti Irani, the HRD minister, formed a new committee and the chairman was T.S.R. Subramanian. They submitted their report according to their survey in 2016. Their objective was to improve the quality of education, fill the gaps that is there in the implementation and the credibility of this education policy. But somehow the recommendations that were given by this committee did not work, and hence a new committee had to be set. A new committee had the chairmanship of Dr. K. Kasturiranjan, and it was made up of 9 members, and they drafted the new education policy that was of 2009. Then the 3 most important things came, that is the HRD ministry was named as the Minister of Education, the GDP investment of 1.6% was increased to 6%. The focus on gross enrollment ratio was given and it has been increased to 50%. Now the academics, extracurricular activities and vocational training will be given equal and same importance. The 10 plus 2 years of study will be divided in 5 plus 3 plus 3 plus 4. That is, the preschool education would also come under the purview of formal education as per the global standards. The students has to learn coding from class 6, and that is what we see in China and so fast growing country it is. Also, till class 5 or till the 5th standard, the mother language or the mother tongue has to be there as a medium. There has to be a 360 degree holistic approach to the report card. It has to be a 360 degree approach of the report card, okay? Now, changes in higher education will be there, like there has to be a flexible curriculum, there has to be vocational training, interdisciplinary combination of subjects, all will be there in the higher education. To implement all these things, the MPhil has been discontinued by the new education policy. Sanskrit will be available in every strata of the education that is being taught. There will be a multidisciplinary approach, and the education research in universities will be under one banner. The Higher Education Commission of India will have the heading of all the universities, all the study courses except medical and legal education that are excluded from this. The changes for the national curriculum framework for the teachers' education was given in this, because the teacher also needed to have some different type of training or education to cope up with the new education policy, because it aimed that whenever a student goes out of the school or college, he must have that knowledge so that he can face the outer world and is ready or fit for the reality. Secondly, by 2030, it will be mandatory for all teachers to have an integrated B.Ed. degree. Applicability has to be checked in the board exam. It will not be something that is marked up by the students. It has to be something that is checking the applicability and the practicality of the student. It will check only the practical aspects. Secondly, and lastly, the private and the government schools will not have any differences. It will only have the same status. Every student in a private and a government school will have the same status. This education policy is very interesting because it gives each and every student their own interest area. They can explore and excel in it. That's all for today. See you in the next video. Bye bye.